At our house, we are preparing for coronavirus infection. We are preparing to stay as well as we know how, to protect others if infected, to get well, God willing, and to die. We are preparing to stay as well as we know how. To do so, we shall strengthen our general immunity by adopting an organic, whole, plant-based diet.
The Lord God commanded the man, saying, "You may surely eat of every tree of the garden.
Practice careful sanitation, especially by washing our hands often with soap and water.
They shall wash their hands and their feet, so that they may not die."
Stay informed by reading and viewing expert media.
"If you will diligently listen and keep all his statutes, I will put none of the diseases on you."
Avoid infected places unless needed there to serve the sick.
To the day of his death, he lived in a separate house.
Procure hygienic masks and learn how to make such masks.
Moses would put a veil over his face.
We are preparing to protect others if infected. Then we shall have family members get tested.
The priest goes to examine the disease, lest all that is in the house be declared unclean.
Wear a hygienic mask.
They do not hesitate to spit at the sight of me.
Sanitize objects and surfaces often.
I will sprinkle clean water on you, and you shall be clean from all your uncleanness.
Post a warning at entrances.
He shall cover his upper lip and cry out, "Unclean, unclean."
And stay isolated for the required time.
Away, unclean. They shall stay with us no longer.
We are preparing to get well, God willing. To do so, we must maintain good nutrition.
Cisterns already hewn, vineyards, olive orchards and fruit trees in abundance.
Pray one for another.
Pray for one another, that you may be healed.
Arrange to care for each other's needs.
Supplying the needs of the saints.
Follow emerging medical advice.
If any of you lacks wisdom, let him ask.
And accept affordable medical care.
The leaves of the tree were for the healing of the nations.
Finally, we are preparing to die. We will lay plans with our family members.
He set his house in order and he died and was buried in the tomb of his father.
Update our final will and testament.
His offspring shall inherit the land.
Arrange for direct cremation without funeral.
They took the body of Saul and the bodies of his sons and burned them there.
Make peace with God.
The peace of God will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus.
And await the resurrection of the just.
You will be repaid at the resurrection of the just.